गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर फिफ्थ ऑफ क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स विल डिस्कस आर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज़ स्पेस क्वांटाइजेशन. सो इन दिस लेक्चर यू विल कम टू नो दैट व्हाट दिस स्पेस क्वांटाइजेशन इज़ ऑल अबाउट. सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड द बिहेवियर ऑफ एटम एज अ मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल अंडर द इफेक्ट ऑफ एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. So, from that article, what we conclude is, we concluded that when an atom, it is placed inside the external magnetic field B, then the angular momentum vector, orbital angular momentum vector, L vector of an electron, it precesses about the direction of the field at an angle theta, such that angle between the orbital angular momentum vector L vector and the magnetic field vector B vector remains constant. And actually what is happening at that time, because we know that the orbit of electron, it is always perpendicular to the direction of angular momentum vector. So if L, it will precess and trace a cone around the direction of B vector at an angle theta, at that time the orbit of electron, it will also precess about the direction of magnetic field B vector as an axis, and this is known as Larmor precession. Now suppose that if the direction of this applied magnetic field B vector, it is along Z direction. Direction of this applied magnetic field is Z axis. And this angular momentum vector L vector, it makes an angle theta with this B vector. So now, what will be the component of this L vector in the direction of this B vector? So we have to find that what will be the component of this orbital angular momentum vector L vector along B vector or in the direction of B vector. Because this B vector, it is in Z direction, therefore there will be Z component of this L vector in the direction of B vector. So we will denote that Z component of this L vector by LZ. And now we will calculate that what is the value of this LZ. How? Take this as right angle triangle. Of this right angle triangle, this LZ is base, this one is perpendicular, and this one is hypotenuse. We have to calculate LZ. So base upon hypotenuse, that is LZ by L, it will be equal to cos theta. So that is why LZ is equal to L cos theta. And what is this LZ? It is the component of orbital angular momentum vector L vector in the direction of B vector. So that is LZ, it is equal to L cos theta. And if we have to calculate theta, then this cos theta will be LZ by L. And quantum mechanically, in our previous semester, we have studied principal quantum number n, orbital quantum number small l, and magnetic quantum number ml. And we have also derived in Bohr's theory, Bohr's model of an atom, that this orbital angular momentum L, it is quantized. How? Because this L, it is equal to root LL plus 1 h cut, where this L is orbital quantum number, and this LZ, it gives the direction to this orbital angular quantum number. This LZ, it provides the direction to this orbital angular momentum of an electron. And we know that in the last semester we have studied that the magnetic quantum number ML decides the direction or the orientation of L vector. And this LZ, it is equal to ML H cut. And both these quantum numbers ML and L both are quantized. Therefore, the orbital angular momentum and the Z component of orbital angular momentum both are quantized. And where this L is orbital quantum number and ML is magnetic quantum number. Now put both of these values of capital L and capital LZ in the equation of cos theta, which is LZ by L. What is LZ? It is ML H cut. What is L? It is root LL plus 1 H cut. And this H cut and H cut will be cancelled out. So this cos theta, it is equal to ML upon root LL plus 1. Now we know that corresponding to single value of L, there are 2L plus 1 values of ML. Because the values of ML are from minus L to plus L including 0. So therefore, there will be corresponding to one value of L, there will be L positive values, L negative values. So L plus L will be 2L and 1 0. So there will be total 2L plus 1 values, possible values of ML corresponding to single value of L. And if corresponding to single value of L, we have 2L plus 1 values of this ML, and this cos theta depends upon ML. Therefore, there will be 2L plus 1 values of this cos theta. And if we have 2L plus 1 values of this cos theta, then there will be 2L plus 1 values of this theta. And what is this theta is actually? This theta, it is the angle between L vector and B vector. And if corresponding to one value of L, there will be single magnitude of this L. But it will have 2L plus 1 directions. Why? Because there will be 2L plus 1 values of theta. And what is theta? It is the angle between L and B. So there will be 2L plus 1 possible orientations of this L vector with respect to B vector. Corresponding to single value of L, the direction magnitude will be constant. Magnitude of L will be same, but its direction, there are 2L plus 1 possible directions of this L vector with respect to B vector corresponding to single value of L. And this is known as quantization of space. So I am repeating again. Corresponding to single value of L, what are the values of ML? It is minus L to plus L including 0. So it will take L positive values, L negative values, total L plus L 2L and 1 0. So total 2L plus 1 values. And if this ML have 2L plus 1 values, because this cos theta depends upon this ML, so cos theta will also have 2L plus 1 discrete values for single value of L. If cos theta has 2L plus 1 values, then theta will automatically have 2L plus 1 discrete values for 1L. And theta is the angle between L vector and B vector. Therefore, this L vector, which is the orbital angular momentum vector, it can have 2L plus 1 angles with respect to B. Means it can have 2L plus 1 discrete orientations with respect to magnetic field. b vector, and this is known as phase quantization, that not every angle of L is possible, not every angle of L is possible, only few of them are possible according to the formula cos theta is equal to ml upon root ll plus 1. Now because ml and ll plus 1 both are quantized, therefore these orientations are also quantized, and this quantization of the orientation of atoms or the orientation of L vector in space, it is known as space quantization. Now we'll take one example. Suppose the value of orbital quantum number L, it is 2. Then what will be the value of orbital angular momentum L? It is equal to this. So its value will be root 2 into 2 plus 1 h cut. So it will be, L will be root 6 h cut. And corresponding to L is equal to 2, what are the corresponding values of ml from minus L to plus L? It means the values of ml will be from minus 2 to plus 2. How many? Minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. So if L is 2, then there will be 2L plus 1 values of ml. Means there will be 5 values of ml. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 values of ml. And corresponding to these 5 values of ml, we will have 5 values of Lz. Corresponding to minus 2, we will have Lz is equal to minus 2 h cut, minus h cut, 0, plus h cut, plus 2 h cut. And corresponding to these 5 values of ml, we will have 5 values of cos theta. Root ll plus 1 is same, that is root 6 h cut and h cut will be cancelled out. So the value of root ll plus 1 is same, that is root 6, but there are 5 values of this ml. So put all these values, so corresponding values of theta will be, corresponding to ml minus 2, it will be minus 2 by root 6, then minus 1 by root 6, then 0 by root 6, plus 1 by root 6, plus 2 by root 6. So these are the 5 values of cos theta, and after solving this, you can find the value of theta. But here cos theta is 0, means here theta will be, cos is 0 corresponding to 90 degree. So here theta is 90 degree. And in all the cases we know that this ml, this mod of ml, it is less than equal to 2. The maximum value of this ml is plus 2. So the mod of ml is less than equal to 2. Either it is less than or it is equal to 2. But when you will solve this root 6, which is the value of root ll plus 1, this root 6, we know that root 5 is 2.32 something. It means this root 6, it is greater than 2. This root 6, it is greater than 2. What is its meaning? That value of this root ll plus 1, in all the 5 cases, it is greater than the value of ml. Numerator is smaller, denominator is greater. What happens when numerator is smaller and denominator is greater? It means cos theta can never be equal to 1. Can never be equal to 1. And if cos theta, it can never be equal to plus 1, it can never be equal to minus 1. It means theta can never be equal to 0 or 180 degree. If cos theta will be plus 1, then theta will be 0 degree. And if cos theta is minus 1, then theta will be 180 degree. It means because the value of this ml, it is always smaller than this root ll plus 1. Therefore, cos theta will never be equal to plus 1 or minus 1. Means theta can never be equal to 0 degree or 180 degree. And what is the meaning of theta equal to 0 degree? Theta equal to 0 degree means theta is the angle between magnetic field vector and L vector. If theta is 0 degree, it means the direction of L vector and B vector is same. And if theta is 180 degree, what does this mean? It means the angle between L and B is 180 degree. It means if direction of B is this, then direction of L will be this. Theta is 180 degree. But what we have concluded from our article? That theta can never be equal to 0 degree. It can never be equal to 180 degree. So this implies that our L vector, it can never be aligned parallel to the magnetic field or anti-parallel to the magnetic field. Why? Because this ml is always less than this. Because of that, this cos theta, it can never be equal to plus minus 1. So that is why theta can never be equal to 0 degree or 180 degree. So here you can see, because of the 5 values of cos theta corresponding to L is equal to 2, we have 5 orientations of L vector. This is theta is equal to 90 degree. This is theta corresponding to ml plus 2. This is theta corresponding to ml plus 1. This is theta corresponding to ml minus 1. This is theta corresponding to ml minus 2. And the magnitude of LZ was 0 h cut, 2 h cut, minus h cut, minus 2 h cut. So this is the magnitude of LZ. And these are the possible discrete 5 orientations, possible orientations of L vector with respect to B vector when L is equal to 2. For L is equal to 2. So similarly, you can design this space quantization for L is equal to 1, for L is equal to 3, and so on. So this is all about space quantization.